Three, two, one.
It's awesome time. What if there was no Google? No problem. Super smart Umsum will answer all your questions.
Oh, Umsum. Without Google, searching might not be as popular as it is today.
If you're happy,
people might talk more as they will ask each other a lot of questions. Also, completely on Google. Secondly, if there were no Google Maps, you still might be using paper-based maps. Thirdly, if there was no Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo Mail might still be popular. Fourthly, if there was no Android, Apple would definitely be more happy. Also, Nokia would be glad as feature phones would still be popular. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, that would be great news for Microsoft Office. Note that, in Google's absence, some other company would have grabbed the opportunity and become as popular and dominant as Google is now. What if we breathe only by mouth?
I only lick lollipops using my mouth.
Oh, Umsum. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign materials, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds warmth and moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
Umsum the Great will start shining and take its place.
Oh, Umsum. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Let's just drop this call.
It's awesome time. What if there was no Google? No problem. Super smart Umsum will answer all
your questions.
Oh, Hamza. Without Google, searching might not be as popular as it is today. People might talk more as they will ask each other a lot of questions. Also, completely on Google. Secondly, if there were no Google Maps, using paper-based maps. Thirdly, if there was no Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo Mail might still be popular. Fourthly, if there was no Android, Apple would definitely be more happy. Also, Nokia would be glad as feature phones would still be popular. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, that would be great news for Microsoft Office. Note that, in Google's absence, some other company would have grabbed the opportunity and become as popular and dominant as Google is now. What if we breathe only by mouth? Nah, I only lick lollipops using my mouth. Oh, I'm sorry. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign materials, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds more thin moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
I'm Sun the Great. We'll start shining and take its place.
Oh, I'm Sun. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Я не знаю.
That's no sneeze. El Sona seems there. Lump, snum, snum, me wolves in the shoe of her wine is the ass. Send noon with the wolves. Egg the awkward goblin. Sit. I'm not gonna say your side from the last. Your third is just your side. That's where we're on the moon. Squirrel, phenol, snither, those snummy wolves in your wine. Suff, snither, sad, please, where we don't win. There ain't no harder in their goblin. See the matter of human sack. You know, I guess. Now, new Murphs, the right for new ones, Zerd says, or see, you're on Surf's own here, where people sit up. Stand, and not as long as you're in the camp, those little white elves are in the earth, and so do you're on the middle of the face, but you stand the white male Surf. That's my what? Well, stay, yes, ning, and yes, sure, so, you're good, my smart. Sure, he was a new Murph at all. I guess go, and then you see, you'll find a new one, and you're getting this up. Oh, fine, though. Yes, Steven. And we should get out of the sky if you remember that book and that ass out in his deep soup sales window. And we should say this natural Mrs. Nash to Steven when I'm a winner at Rip Snurp Scouts. Remember it, Skinny? Almost. And we should another snatch to us and ask out as we look at it. And we guess. He's here if not, Neil Shoes and ask out so he feels her. Yeah, ask out the name is Seal of Funnel Will for the way. Yes, it's sung as Ox, no deal, yelling if he eats nuts, this snap. Sarah sits as you get a poor white man, all bad to see him open up. The loss of Elskite Nazari, but Nancy Oakburn said nothing if he was. Stand on the alpha, but Sarah's just sitting long enough to need a sock, silver wolf, the sin gets, this is niche dip, said it. The wolf may know if you're not in the city. The loss of the elf, Nancy, first skim with all the wrong, was it Nancy Oakburn? That's not what. Ask you, another elf, man. A large one. Ask you, because they're all 3 feet away. I just saw us getting to the east of the Zark Snoop in the ship. I feel since losing my inviolables. My inviolables since the was long in the year 5 years out. And offer wine in the Shabba Cat was the only thing in the year 5 years out. You'll earth. See, I'm off the dodge and I'm off the sneaker with the limb in the year 5 years. There's no sneaky, you'll guess. There's the fact that we're off snake as a gesture, but no man is it. A Viala said, there it's there, it's it. A Viala survived by the Irish flag having in the airfield surf. There's the name of the city of Olaf, but the flag having in the airfield. Irish hero strip several Irish folk, but it's your own Miss Gimson. Great, boy, and he just got you on it from the Nazarene. He'll sell. There's the scoff, a seal, the aroma, a little snob, seriously, Miss Lawson. Guys, God, you're standing here, almost a seal, you're in the airfield. This is your last son. Where's the old fire's life in the bus? Who underwent is a green area? He'll surf. Such as if never mind as I do in the army there. A small up. I'm a sweet spot. I'm a little more. I'm a bit more than your real fiddle. And still, who says, and I might narrowly pop some of the need in a strip by the fire. But we don't like the must. This man is a good me. That good. I'm not sure if you're a good person. Look, now you evil, but now you're a good person. I'm a little bit of a snake. Oh no!
If there was no cheaper, I would have been a man's right to be bothered. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, I would be great news from Microsoft Office.
we breathe only by mouth? I only like lollipops using my mouth. Oh, I'm sorry. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign material, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds more thin moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand? No problem. I am quicker than quicksand. Oh, I'm so. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and soda. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. It starts behaving like liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared? I'm some the Great. We'll start shining and take its place. Oh, I'm sorry. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers, as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster, and thus our days would be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on Moon have already proved that it has protected Earth from a thousand of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller, as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, Moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Only like lollipops using my mouth. Oh, I'm sorry. Just breathe.
out of question. Also, as compared to relying completely on Google. Secondly, if there were no Google Maps, it's likely using paper-based maps. Thirdly, if there was no Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo Mail might still be popular. Fourthly, if there was no Android, Apple would definitely be more happy. Also, Nokia would be glad as feature phones would still be popular. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, that would be great news for Microsoft Office. Note that, in Google's absence, some other company would have grabbed the opportunity and become as popular and dominant as Google is now. What if we breathe only by mouth? I only lick lollipops using my mouth. Oh, breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign materials, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds warmth and moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion.
That's like
what if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, awesome. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
Umsum the Great will start shining and take its place.
Oh, Umsum. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on Moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Let's memorize our multiplication facts.
No problem. Super smart awesome.
Yankee Doodle went to town. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 23, 24, 26, 28, and 30. Are you sleeping? 3, 6, 9.
Also, you can't
breathe only by mouth?
Nah, I only lick lollipops using my mouth.
Oh, Amsa, breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign material, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds warmth and moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, fine, sir. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
I'm Sun the Great. We'll start shining and take its place.
Oh, I'm sorry. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate. It's awesome time. What if there was no Google?
No problem. Super smart Awesome will answer all your questions.
Oh, Awesome. First, without Google, searching might not be as popular as it is today. People might talk more as they will ask each other a lot of questions. Also, completely on Google. Secondly, if there were no Google Maps, how would we be using paper-based maps? Thirdly, if there was no Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo Mail might still be popular. Fourthly, if there was no Android, Apple would definitely be more happy. Also, Nokia would be glad as feature phones would still be popular. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, that would be great news for Microsoft Office. Note that, in Google's absence, some other company would have grabbed the opportunity and become as popular and dominant as Google is now. What if we breathe only by mouth?
Nah, I only lick lollipops using my mouth.
Oh, Awesome. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering. more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
I'm some the Great. We'll start shining and take its place.
Oh, I'm some. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Let's just drop this.
It's awesome time. What if there was no Google?
No problem. Super smart Umsum will answer all your questions.
Oh, Umsum. First, without Google, searching might not be as popular as it is today. People might talk more as they will ask each other a lot of questions. Also, lying completely on Google. Secondly, if there were no Google Maps, people might be using paper-based maps. Thirdly, if there was no Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo Mail might still be popular. Fourthly, if there was no Android, Apple would definitely be more happy. Also, Nokia would be glad as feature phones would still be popular. Lastly, if there was no Google Docs, then it would be great news for Microsoft Office. Note that, in Google's absence, some other company would have grabbed the opportunity and become as popular and dominant as Google is now. What if we breathe only by mouth?
Nah, I only lick lollipops using my mouth.
Oh, Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, air and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign materials, dust, allergens, etc. Which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds more thin moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases the stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared?
I'm Sum the Great. We'll start shining and take its place.
Oh, I'm Sum. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate. Was it? long as your plot heals out. And Opera went in his tub, but that was the thing in his plan that the old troops got to be of Earth. See, the Earth and Osh are now murderous. The Earth and the Elium in their plan, so we need to be revolutionary. The only guess is the fact that the world is negative, so the Earth will be in a city. Of the Alice, the Elium observes it. Of the Alice, or what was the Alice?
So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid.
But when we step on it, our weight increases to stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if the moon disappeared? I'm Sum the Great. We'll start shining and take its place. Sum. Firstly, our nights would definitely be darker. Due to this, night predators like owls would find it very difficult to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus our days will be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on Moon are a proof that it has protected Earth from thousands of asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as only sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, Moon's disappearance might tilt Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Unless it's dropped.
Good job. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, the iron mucus this, no one else helping think at all. You have the best elegance in selling. Second, no joke. This is 1 acre contract. You are so deeply responsible for your release cost. Lastly, Nose adds one thing that you can do your new. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by nose has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by nose requires a bit more saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is able to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crickets or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem.
I am quivering in quicksand. Oh, tough shot. Quicksand is a water-logged mixture of sand and quicksand. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, in order to stop the quicksand, it appears and acts like a solid. When you step on it, however, it increases the stress. Hence, it stops behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and pulled them to mimic the action of a bad human, they made safe, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand. What if a man disappeared? I'm Sam the Great. We'll start shaming and take its place. Oh, I'm sorry. Firstly, television would definitely be darker. Due to this, many predators like owls would find it very hard to hunt at night. But this would be great news for stargazers as there is no interference from moonlight. Secondly, as the Moon's gravity is no longer there to hold the Earth, it would rotate faster and thus nowadays would be much shorter than 24 hours. Craters on Moon are incorporated as protected on 5,000 asteroids and comets. This no longer will be the case. With the Moon missing, tides in our oceans will be much, much smaller as our sun will slightly influence them. Changing tides will also influence the global weather patterns. Finally, Moon's disappearance wipes our Earth's axis drastically, causing extreme changes in seasons and climate.
Yes,